Hello, hello, everybody. What is going on?
Oh, I just changed the music. Oops.
What's up, everybody? How is it going? How's it hanging? It is Thursday. You know that what that means. It means it's another stream, obviously, of course. Sundays, Tuesdays, Thursdays. Never fails. I mean, sometimes. Sheepy boy, hello, my friend. Time Watcher, hello. Phoenix Lord, good to see you. It's been a little while. Hope everyone is having a fantastic Thursday. Happy Veterans Day, everyone, and to all who have served. Can't believe every veteran was born on this day. Happy birthday, everybody. It is a holiday, so we had it off from work today to celebrate all the birthdays. And with that, I only have the two more days of the work week, and then we're good. So yahoo to that. As for tonight, we're gonna hang out a little bit. We're gonna chill. It's gonna be fairly relaxing, low-key, but I heavily think that we can beat Metroid Dread tonight, especially since I only need like one more power-up, and then pretty sure we're fighting the boss, and that should be it, which is kind of crazy that we are so close. I think this game was a decent length. Looks like we do have one more Emmy to fight though, and so I think there's a bit of depth that we can do, a bit that we can get into tonight, and so I'm stoked for that. Let's see. I didn't post on Twitter because I feel like going live tweets do nothing. Although I could just do a gif of my face. Night be the night I finally beat Metroid Dread. How do I want to do this tweet? Will I beat Metroid Dread tonight? Not optimistic. Chatting for a bit before jumping into the action. And then a gif of me. There we go. That's how we do going live tweets. Make him move my face. Is the title supposed to be unqualified streamer advice? Why would it not be? Do I look like the kind of man who makes mistakes? No, sir. No, no, no. There will be an abundance of unqualified streamer advice. Hello, how is my favorite streamer today? I'm sure PewDiePie is doing fine. What's up, AD? It's good to see you. Hello, Tyler. I'm listening to stream on the way home. I'll try not to distract you. Turn left! Alright. Well, just drive safe. Be okay. I appreciate you listening in. We'll treat it like a podcast. This episode of Skyquake is sponsored by Squarespace. Do you like building websites for a fraction of the cost? Join Squarespace. I hope everyone is doing well. I had a good day today. I made a ridiculous purchase a couple of days ago. I bought a guitar. I bought a guitar. And it is dope. It's so cool. It's so fucking cool. I love it. And I posted it. I posted a very bad picture on Twitter. Because Fiona, as I was taking a picture, just walked over and just sat there and smiled at me. I'm like, all right, I gotta get her in the picture. Let me bring this up.
Your kind words are appreciated.
AD, thank you for extending your tier one sub through November. Your double subs always confuse me. And I don't know why they always show up as double subs. And also, when you extend a sub, it doesn't show up in my alerts. I just see that come through chat. I don't understand it. I'm not going to complain. Thank you for extending your sub. I appreciate that. What brand? Ibanez. I got an Ibanez whatever. Use code Skyquake in chat when you create a website using Squarespace. I stumbled over all my words because I'm just getting too excited about the sponsorship deal. That's not true. I am not sponsored by Squarespace. 34%, you dishonor me? How dare you, sir? How dare you? I heard most people will end Metroid Dread at around like 40%. I am average. But anyway, let me bring up. Wrong one. There we go. I bought a thing. I bought a guitar. And Fiona decided to crash the picture. She's like, oh, hey, you're doing a thing? Not without me. And so I got an Ibanez. It's green and it's dope. Some people may ask, oh, what sparked your interest in buying a guitar? I don't know. Look cool. Do you know how to play guitar? I don't understand the question. Next question, please. You bought cardboard? Oh my God. So I was like, yeah, I bought a thing. Someone's like, that's a nice dog bed you have back there. Thanks, Pine. Jackie was like, oh, hey, nice cardboard. Angel? That's how you pronounce it. We followed each other for a while. I just don't know how to pronounce his name. Angel was like, oh, you got carpet. I'm like, surprisingly, one of the closer guesses. Gibson said the blue controller that was way in the background over here. And I'm like, no. You morons. It's the guitar. It's the big guitar in the middle. You fucking hooligans. But it's very nice. Got that crisp green. I love it. It was only like $200 on Amazon. And the way I see it, it is, I'm going to be much more likely to play it and practice just like riffs and stuff on an electric guitar that I don't need to plug in. And I can just play, especially if like Emily is sleeping and I'm up late and I want to just practice a few things, not plugging it into my amp. It's going to be nice and quiet. And I have an acoustic guitar that I haven't touched in like 7 years. 7 years. So I've forgotten all the riffs that I used to know. And that's just been sitting in the closet and I never feel like breaking it out. Is it a 6-string or 7-string? 6. It's a standard, just basic guitar. You bought a dog? She is cute, isn't she? That's Fiona, our little trash gremlin. Who has never seen a groomer in her life, and it shows. I can't even play the ukulele well. I don't know how people play guitar. Oh, it's you just got to commit to one. I feel like I'd struggle more with the ukulele. One, because I don't like it as much. It's like playing a first act, my first guitar for like 6-year-olds, which I have played. You need a drummer? Hit me up. Oh, I am not making a band right now. I need to learn a single chord before we start talking that way. But I also had to make sure to get the checkerboard guitar strap. Because if there's anything at all, just throw a little ska spice into it. Gotta be checkerboard something. It didn't look green in the first picture? I mean, I think so. Learning is overrated. Just start calling yourself a rock star. I'm not gonna just put a title on my name and pretend I'm the best at something when I'm not. Other than the fact that I'm the face of the electric guitar Twitch community, doesn't mean I'm a rock star. I'll stick with being the face of the Metroid Dread Twitch community first, and then we'll go from there. Hey, Diana. Thank you so much for calling me the face of the Just Chatting Twitch community. Man, boy, it's been ages since I've heard that. Hello. Maybe I have boomer eyes. Yeah, I mean, I didn't want to say it. But Fiona was very happy for me. Squake, this is the internet. If you're not actively jerking yourself off, who even are you? That's what the OnlyFans is for. So no, don't get me wrong. That does happen. Anyway. Yes, that is my big reckless purchase. Which again, it was only like $200 and I think it looks rad. And don't get any ideas. I'm not playing it. Oh, the green screen. I just hit my headset with it. The green screen is chroma keying it out. can I fix that? Can I fix that, please? I cannot. That's okay. Yeah, it's right here. Very nice. I'm not gonna play it because I don't know how to play it, but I figure this is gonna be a good way to practice. And it's sturdy. It's hefty. I like the top too. I like the shape of that. I'm so used to having three strings on each side, so that was a little interesting to tune. But I like it. My dream for like years now, and I've never told anybody this, so keep it secret, is that, hey Snow, how's it going? My dream, for whatever reason, ever since like YouTube started, I've always loved the videos that are like someone playing a bit of a song and then live looping it. It kind of like how I have my sampler on my Go XLR, where I could like make noises and have it loop and sample and stuff like that. I love when videos do that with songs, and it's just one person creating an entire song with a looper. And I would love to do that with like a random song, is to make a video of me playing every single part. But I don't have a drum kit, so I'd have to make that. I don't have any software, so I'd have to get that. I don't have any skills, so I'd have to buy those somewhere. So there's a lot that's going to go into it, and so that is probably never going to happen, but I've always loved those videos. I think that would be super cool. That's a strong shaft? Oh, I always do. Next question. Having dreams in 2021? Oh, yeah. Man. Rare. Musician stream when? Oof. Almost never. Out of fear of copyright, and I'm bad. Yeah, I thought that shit was cool. I thought that was neat. And I'm excited to learn. Oh, I resubbed and got the fancy year badge? I didn't get an alert, so I'm gonna pretend that didn't happen. Hi, Dave. If you're bad, you won't get copyright. Big brain moves over here. Dave, thank you so much for resubscribing for the year. Enjoy your fancy rainbow badge. We also have, for anyone who hasn't been around in a little while, we have some more emotes. They are not mine. Well, that's not true. If you've given a certain amount of bits, you have a few emotes. Followers now have emotes. So if you are not a sub, you still have channel emotes. They are just very basic default emotes that Twitch gave me. And then me looking pissed. But those are there for you. So if you are not a sub, you get to hang out and enjoy it a little bit. Yeah, that was previously called Squangy, but it needed to have the Skyqua prefix to it. And so I had to change that. Once I uploaded it from Better Twitch TV to Twitch. So the fact that I now have 5 follower emotes, 5 tier 1 emotes, a tier 2, a tier 3, and then 5 bit emotes, where if you have cheer over 1,000 bits, 2,500, 5,000 bits, and 70, 7,500 bits, you get emotes on off of those too. So if you have cheered that much, or if you typically have a bit badge, you should have an emote that goes with it. So check for those as well. Have you heard of Twitch Prime, Diana? I have heard of Twitch Prime. It's when you link your Amazon Prime to your Twitch account, you get a free sub every 30 days. The only thing is that it doesn't auto-renew. So it may just be sitting there watching, wondering when you are going to be using it. So all that I ask is that you click the subscribe button. You don't have to use it here. You just need to see if you have a sub waiting for you. Because every day that you don't use that Twitch Prime sub, 17 cents goes to Daddy Jeff. He doesn't need those 17 cents. He's already been to space twice. So I'd much rather have that money and have it go to a good cause and grow the community, and you get perks on top of that. Emotes, ad-free viewing, exclusive role in the Thunder Buddy Discord. So all I ask is just to consider using your Twitch Prime sub here. So Prime checks, who has them sitting there waiting? I know mine just came up today. So I need to figure out who I want to use that on. So anyone, any primers? Anyone have a free Prime lying around? Let's see it. Let's hear it. So yes, Diana, to answer your question, obviously I've heard of Twitch Prime. Thank you for asking. I want it to sit on this screen. I changed the music again. There we go. I always forget about my Twitch Prime. Well, do you have one now? Daddy Jeff, oh yes! Papa Jeff! Papa Bezos! If you don't think for a second he's still getting that money, he's not getting that bag from Amazon, you are sorely mistaken. Sorry for asking, but are you wearing the same flannel as the last stream? I knew someone would ask. The answer is no, because I have like three of these. And also, sometimes I wear flannels over again, over a couple of days. This is not one of them. This is brand new. Brand new. It was washed. But yeah, I have like three red flannels. Some are darker than others. This is like one of my brightest ones. Other ones are more like a maroon. This is like my favorite red one because it's so bright. I got the Discord hoodie. I'm sorry, the Discord shirt. From PAX East 19. Gotta grab candy? Ooh, what are you getting? Report back. I'm scrolling up because I know I missed a few messages. I've been trying to teach myself to draw again. Got a tablet and everything. No time to practice, though. Kaiser, stick to it. Let us know how it goes. Do you need that motivation? Do you need us to be like, hey, show us the next drawing. Show us the next illustration. Will that motivate you? Because that's where I feel like that works for me. If people are expecting something of me, or they're like, oh, hey, let me know how that goes, I gotta tell them how that goes. It do be like that. I should make him go pet the puppy right now and we'll never see him again. I will say, if you choose pet the puppy, I am not going to grab it because, grab the puppy because she's sleeping right now. I'd refund the points. How's the Squake Lock video going? I don't understand the question. It's like 95% done. I walked right into that. Oh yeah, Sheep's right. The new thing with streams is we start with just chatting for a little while, and I think it works. I think it brings everyone in here. And it's better than sitting on like a starting soon screen for 8 minutes. I'll do a starting soon screen for like 2 minutes because I know people are like, oh, what if I miss gameplay immediately? This way I get to catch up, tell people how everything's going, check in with everybody else because this is a conversation. This is between me and you, not just me. It's more you talking to the face of the Metroid Dread Twitch community, but it is talking nonetheless. gives time to show your rad guitar skills. Oh my god, my countless skills and endless guitar knowledge, like the C chord and hammer-ons. Yeah. I'm very excited about the guitar, though. It's less procrastination and more, hey, you have 7 million other things to do that will directly affect your living space if you don't handle it now. Priorities. Understandable. Understandable. I'm in a weird headspace. It's Friday and I'm trucking along with work, multitasking to the max. My ADHD is pleased with so many things going on. Good. Good. I'm happy to hear that. And I do appreciate everyone jumping in to the beginning of stream. We've been here already for 25 minutes, which has felt like five. And I'm feeling good. I hope you guys are having a good day. And I really appreciate everyone coming in at the beginning of stream. Never forget that I appreciate you being here. What the fuck? It's been 25 minutes. What is time? Oh, yeah, it's fake. Time's an illusion. Social construct. That's what they want you to believe. Yeah, things are feeling good. I'm in a good mood. I had a good day today. It was a stressful day. Ran a lot of errands and got a lot of stuff done. Talked to a few people, but stressful day, but a good day. And I'm glad to just be sitting here relaxing, playing video games, talk with my friends. Oh, man. I mostly just, like, I can't stop looking at the guitar. It's super cool. And again, I wish I could just be like, oh, yeah, I know how to play. Give me a second. And then just bust out. But no, that is not the case. And you will not see me doing that for a while. I haven't showed the kittens in a long time. I should do that. Yes, please do, Phoenix. That's what we like. We like checking in. With cats. You got an animal? I better fucking know about it. That goes for all of you. This is a not a request, but a demand. If you have animal pictures that you have not posted in my Discord and you're in my Discord, don't expect to be in my Discord for much longer. It's a rule. It's a rite of passage. It is hazing, whatever you want to call it. It is a requirement that you post your good boys and girls. I want to see those good boys. Post them in the post your pets section. I haven't shown my dog yet. You have a dog that you haven't shown us? And I modded this kid? What is wrong with me? God, I gotta do fucking background checks first. Oh my god. This person is in a position of power. And we have not seen their good boy yet. I'm more questioning my ethics. My mod application process. Anyone want to be mod? Apparently, I just give them away for free. Throw caution to the wind. Fuck the rules, they say. Reckless decisions. Classic Squake. God. God, anyone can be a mod these days. Christ. Trustworthy? No. Need dog pics? Must. Yes. Absolutely. Anyway. I was just happy to post a picture of Fiona earlier, which I knew that the picture of the guitar was blurry and there was shit in the background, but that picture was just so funny. I'll be a mod, I won't abuse the power. You are the last person that I would give mod to. The last person, or if you have to tell me I won't abuse my power as the first introduction to this informal interview process, no. It's like going into a game studio, be like, hey, I won't leak any games. What are you working on? Sorry, you're going to have to sign this NDA. No. You can tell me. Source, trust me, bro. unreal. What's a bathtub? And Raven the Gatekeeper. God, badass name. Badass name. Just finished a 4-to-6-page paper that ended up being 8 pages due on mass incarceration. Was due tonight at midnight, so of course I basically did all of it today. I typically say due tomorrow, due tomorrow. Which means due today, due today. If you know, you know. I'm arrived home, stream can finally start. Oh. What is up, everybody? Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome on in. It's your boy, Squake, jumping in, and oh my god, Tyler? Wow. Wow, Tyler is here immediately at the start of stream. It's crazy, I've always liked that guy. He's a little shady at times, a little shifty. It's a weird thing for Funko Pops, but other than that, he's all right in my book. I did do a paper that was due tonight to yesterday, so that was a win. That was a win for me. Hell yeah. We on that grind. Except the grind is just pain and suffering and not fun at all.
Oh, hi. Thanks for checking in. I'm still a piece of garbage.
Raven!
Well, look at that.
Well, look at that. 47 months. One away from 4 years. That is insane. Raven, thank you so much. You are the first person to require me to move my alerts a little bit more because your name is too long. What's up with that? Can I do this again?
Oh, hi. Thanks for checking in. I'm still a piece of garbage.
Whoa, look at that.
Whoa, look at that. Your name is too long. You should change it. I heard all about your green guitar, and you need to use today's sponsor, Skillshare, to learn how to play. My god, you're right. I forgot about the sponsor, Skillshare, along with Masterclass. Get 15% off when you use code SQUAKYPOO at checkout. What are we blaming the tub for? Oh yeah, yeah, changing the name. Life stuff, BRB, good luck. No, I'm glad the stream can finally start now that Tyler has finally made his presence known. We've been waiting, wondering, when can we begin? When can we start doing ad reads? When is Nick going to leak his OnlyFans? Now. The answer is now. I'm feeling feisty tonight. I'm ready to fight. Just simply use guitar. You're right. Use guitar. Get babes. Profit. Don't tell the woman I'm going to marry that I just said that. Yes, guitar equals success. OnlyFans command when? Oh god, I should add an OnlyFans command, shouldn't I? I have not posted anything to OnlyFans. I want to see if Morphos has added any. I hope he didn't. Okay, no, he didn't add anything, thankfully. OnlyFans command just says Squakebot say no. Exclamation point OnlyFans, Squakebot says bitch pay me. I don't do that shit for free. Exclamation point premium Snapchat. It's about cross-pollinating. Cross-posting content. Multiple avenues of revenue. Oh yeah, we're all going to hoarding jail. just Fiona pictures? I've thought about it. I've thought about just posting Fiona pictures. Can I set my prices? I assume I can. We're jumping on to OnlyFans. Do I need to... Let me take a look here. What can my first post be? New post. Oh, do I need to set like a payment method first? I think I have to. Oh, I can put my Amazon wish list on here. I can make my OnlyFans free. I wish I was joking that I genuinely don't know how the site works. Probably better that way. My credit card is ready. Oh my God. You all need to calm down. I need to hose you down. Back. Back. Jesus. Maybe I should use that. I thought about using that in Fan House just for Fiona pictures. You wish you were joking that you didn't know how the site works, so you do know. I think I was more trying to say that, like, because I said those words and I'm like, oh, that didn't come out right. I was more saying that, like, I wasn't pretending, like, oh, how does this site work? I don't know. I genuinely don't know. Shut up. Again, this, it's like one of those things, I've said this before, where it's like you see the words come out of your mouth and you just wish you could grab them and put them back, but no, they are out in the world, recorded. There's video evidence. I'm here to make it look like you did know. I don't. Although I did, when I claimed my name on OnlyFans, I did get an invite from a random user. I was like, hey, subscribe to my OnlyFans for free. And I'm like, I didn't. But I thought about it. Also, it was only for 24 hours, so it expired by the time I looked at it. I mean, I think it was expired. I would have had to click on that to figure that out. But you know, I didn't. I didn't click on the account. Do you have a stream archive channel? I do. It is. Twitch has the most recent 2 months worth of streams, but I also upload them to Skyquake VODs on YouTube. I just have not uploaded that or updated that in a while, so I do think that is behind. And also, I have not titled and descriptioned everything, but let me take a look here. Wrong one. Yeah, so I do have Skyquake VODs, and I haven't actually unprivated any in like 7 months, but I have a bunch uploaded that I've been meaning to get to. So if anything, you mentioning that is reminding me to do that. And so, like, if we take a look at, I'm gonna hide the screen for a second just so I don't reveal anything. Give me a second. So yeah, Skyquake on YouTube and Skyquake VODs on YouTube. Subscribe. Oh my God. Brad. The Brad. Brad, that sexy fucking bastard. The handsomest man this side of the Mississippi. The only man who has my heart forever and always. That Brad? Oh. Bye, buddy. I miss you. Tell him I love him. Tell him his dick's looking nice. He's looking nice. I miss him. Anyway. So yeah, I have a bunch of different VODs uploaded that are not Kingdom Hearts. I have the Squake Lock that I am keeping private until I make videos out of them. I have a bunch of Dead by Daylight, Final Fantasy, this and that, but they're all private because I want to add just titles, descriptions, and take a look at the copyright claims. But yes, that would be the channel to do it. It's going to be Skyquake VODs, and it's going to be the one with my face and the number 2 next to it. His what now? His what? He's an attractive man. He knows it. I know it. What? I'm gonna lurk for a bit. All right, Raven. Appreciate the lurk. I just subbed to both channels. Phoenix, thank you so much. Are your Resident Evil 8 VODs there? Yes, they should be. That should include my speedruns, too. Yes, all of... my initial playthrough, I didn't get a chance to upload. I missed it because I forgot to upload these. And I think I'm probably late to these, too. But my speedruns are on here. So we have that to look forward to. And I want to take a look here. Deathloop Day 1. That might be a problem. Okay. All right, great. So as long as I start uploading these within the next, 2 weeks, we'll be up to date. So I uploaded Deathloop Day 1 to YouTube, but it's private right now. I did a League stream, Deathloop, Smash, Smash, Dread, Smash, Smash, 3 Just Chattings, 2 DVDs, and this is the second of Dread. So I have all of these to upload as well. So yes, not the main story of Resident Evil 8, but the speedruns. We're both cracking up. He said, I'm victorious. He has my heart forever. I miss him. I can't wait to see him soon. You're in a weird headspace today? I mean, I wouldn't say that. I just calls him like I sees him. Yes, if anyone hasn't subscribed to my YouTube, why? Thought. Just why? We got Pokemon videos coming out soon. When I say soon, I do mean soon. I just need to work on them. First Pokemon videos, I'd say 95% done. Got to work on that. And I also said that before. But I promise I do need to work on that. And that should be released whenever. I'm done giving ETAs because I always fail them. But I know as soon as I release the first one, the second one's it's going to come right after. That's just how my brain's going to work. Did I watch Venom, Eternals, or Dune? I heard Venom wasn't great, Eternals wasn't great, and Dune looks pretentious. So I say Space Jam 2. That's my way of saying I haven't seen any of them. I know you guys were talking about it in Discord, though. I haven't watched many movies lately. I'm more of a TV show guy. It's hard for me to sit down and actually just watch a movie for whatever reason. We just finished Hulu's Only Murders in the Building. Has anyone seen that yet? Has Steve Martin, Martin Short, and Selena Gomez? It's 10 episodes. Each are like a half an hour. And it is incredible. I love Steve Martin and Martin Short. Especially Martin Short's starring role. You know him. You love him. The fact that he didn't win an Oscar for this I'm just gonna do this again. Martin Short is Jack Frost in the Santa Claus 3. My favorite. I'm mostly joking. I just love Martin Short. I think he's great. Him, Steve Martin, Selena Gomez, fantastic. It is about the three of them. Someone was murdered in their apartment building in New York, and they start a true crime podcast while they're trying to figure it out. Genuinely fantastic. It is so, so good. Evan, that's on my short list of things to watch soon. What's above that list, Dave? What show is at the top of your list that I'm telling you to watch instead of Only Murders in the Building? It's Ted Lasso. Ted Lasso. Fucking watch Ted Lasso. God. Oh, I'm so angry with you right now. Us Mythic Quest, bitch. We've done this back and forth before. I've been asking you to watch Ted Lasso for way longer than you've been telling me to watch Mythic Quest. You told me to watch 30 Rock, and I did. You told me to watch Community, and I did. You told me to play Saints Row, and I did. What more do you want from me before you listen to me? You never listen to me anymore. I still haven't finished Midnight Mass because it low-key stresses me out. Oh, you got to power through Midnight Mass. That shit's really good. And that's only 7 episodes. Tyler, I'm glad that you're almost done with Only Murders in the Building. We binged the last like 4 or 5 episodes last night. We had been watching 1 or 2 in the mornings before work. And then we didn't have work today. So last night we're like, we got to finish it. And we watched 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And it was amazing. I'll watch it soon. Our conversation about it the other day reassured me I will like it. Don't make me pre-sequel. Out of all of the things that I have listened to, you can't pull fucking pre-sequel out on me. During college, I made a bet with Dave. It wasn't really a bet. It was more like a promise, a genuine promise with my entire soul that I was going to beat Borderlands the pre-sequel before we graduated. He had been pressuring me to do it like junior year, and I said by the end of senior year I'm going to finish Borderlands the pre-sequel. Six years later, I have not touched it. No. Me and Dave played it a couple of years ago. Yeah. Exactly, Dave. Exactly. We started it. We played it again. And we still didn't beat it. We got about halfway, maybe 2/3 of the way through. I was still in my other apartment. And so it was at least 2 years ago. Probably closer to 3. And we never beat pre-sequel. It's not a great game, Dave. It's not good. It's not a must-play. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. It is a garbage game with poo-poo movement and trash mechanics. But yeah, no, it's fine. It's just the unlikable characters, the abysmal voice acting, and the gunplay that is no different than Borderlands 2. But no, it's like, it's fine. I'm exaggerating. It's not that bad. You've been watching an episode or a night after work? That's a good idea. Yeah, you should finish that soon, though. Have you ever watched The Princess Bride? I love The Princess Bride. That is a great movie. I've only seen it a couple of times, and they were like years apart. I saw it when I was a kid. I saw it with Emily when we first started dating. Could definitely use a rewatch, though. Tired, got e-learning tomorrow. Good night. Good night, Phoenix. Hope you have a good rest of your night, buddy. Post cat pictures if you haven't already. Brad and Lydia just watched that like 2 nights ago. Oh, yeah. The Princess Bride, it is great. Also, just check your phone. My phone's off. So, is he gonna send me a picture of him pooping like he sends to Ryan. So I don't want to turn on my phone for this. My phone's turning on right now. So I'll check it in a second. I will tomorrow. That is fair. Good night, Phoenix. But yeah, what are some other shows that we've binged recently? I am thinking about starting New Girl. Because Dave has told me to watch New Girl, and I respect his opinions when he makes a thoughtful recommendation on something he thinks I'll enjoy. I really take it to heart, I listen, and then I act upon it. Watch Ted Lasso. Have you watched Squid Game? That's actually, I saw one episode last week and haven't watched anything since. I gotta text my friend Brad. Phone's down because I gotta focus on you, you all. Yeah, I saw one episode of Squid Game, and I have seen quite a few spoilers, not just from all the memes of Squid Game, of like all the games that they play, but also like the day of my friend Justin's wedding. I saw a video of it while we were waiting for pictures to be done. Am I dropping frames? Okay, it should be done now. There might be a hiccup in stream quality, and I don't know why. So just hold tight with that. It looks like it might be a network issue. Either way, so my Facebook, weirdly enough, is just flooded with like clips of TV shows and movies. And a lot of them have like crazy music playing over them and like Korean subtitles. So they're clearly just like illegal rips of shows and movies and stuff that they just throw on random, sometimes verified Facebook pages just to get millions of views. And it works. I get hooked. It's how I discovered The Resident on Fox. It's a medical drama that's just genuinely good. And a few other shows like Chicago PD and Chicago Med, which I'm not going to sit down and watch, but I'll watch 10 minutes of it while I'm working. But one of the clips that they showed on my Facebook was Squid Game. And I was like, oh, that's crazy. It was red light, green light. And so it must have been just when it hit Netflix. I'm like, oh, this is just a random foreign movie or something. And I looked up all the spoilers for it. I don't remember a lot of them, thankfully. I don't remember exactly how the show ends or anything about the characters. I knew mostly about the games, and that's about it. And I'm like, oh, yeah, this will never take off. Worldwide phenomenon. So with that, I have seen one episode, and I'm excited to see more because it was very interesting. Even if I knew the game, like leading up with the characters and everything was super cool. And so that is on my list. I have a list. I have things I want to watch. I want to get through It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. That's more of a background show of like, oh, yeah, this is easy to watch. Can throw on any episode. It's not groundbreaking, but it's a good watch. Oh, yeah. Well, like, it's interesting enough. And so we're definitely going to finish that, especially since it's, what, 6 episodes? Not bad. Yeah, there's a lot that I want to watch. Again, mostly shows, not necessarily movies, but I mean, I like movies. Just I lean more towards those that I can sit, watch anywhere from an hour to 30 minutes of a show and then move on. Oh, 9 episodes, each an hour excluding episode 8, which is shorter. Oh, I didn't know that. I thought it was 6. Maybe there's just like 6 games and that's where that number is coming from. Yeah, It's Always Sunny, Mythic Quest. I want to watch New Girl. But the first time I watched New Girl, I only got through like 4 episodes, and I'm like, oh god, this is insufferable. But that was back in college. And maybe it's just something where I can start on season 2 or something, get to know the characters once they're a little bit more fleshed out, and then jump back to season 1. Had to do that with It's Always Sunny. When I was showing that to Emily, I'm like, oh, these characters are so funny. It's like Arrested Development where you like they're like not great people, but they're funny and you like them kind of thing. And the first episode of It's Always Sunny drops like 7 N-bombs. I'm like, bad first impression. So we just jumped to like season 7, have been watching most of that. We finally understand the characters a little bit more, and then we'll probably go back to season 1 of It's Always Sunny after that, but yikes. Yikes, yikes, yikes. Stream quality looking a little better? I think it should be. Anyway. Yeah, I'm not seeing many issues now. Anyway, we've been chatting for a bit. We have harassed each other, we've hit on each other, we have pressured each other to do things, to complete things, sexual favors, leak the OnlyFans. We have been all over the place tonight. You want to play some video games? Thoughts? Raise of hands? Ones in chats? I think video games sounds good. I do like myself a video games. Wrong one. There we go. I hate video games. What? Oh shit, you got games on your phone? Yo, I got games on my phone. It's a big phone though. It's like a tablet. It's super weird. You can't make calls, but it's like it fits in your pocket. And it's super weird. And the controllers suck. They're always drifting all over the place. Yeah, I got video games. You should have a neon sign that says Cozy Chaos. That's not a bad idea. I like the idea of the neon. Video games are for losers? Wow, harsh. Especially people who like The Legend of Zelda in particular. Those are the biggest dorks. Dave, I looked at that. I'm like, is that Jackie? Like, that emote looks like Jackie, and I just hovered over. It absolutely is. Dude, I want to be a partner so I get animated emotes. Can we make that happen? Can everyone who's in here phone 2 friends? And then have them phone 2 friends? And then we'll build like a pyramid structure of support? You know, I'll follow you, you follow me. Then we get 2 people to then follow up. And it's just that triangle structure to success. Who's in? Say I. You want to work from home? You want to be your own boss? You want to make $700 a week? Tub and Goblin are my 2. Raven, you've brought in like 5. You're good. You're set. You're on the road to success. You're like a platinum level superstar. I'm trying to think of the most preposterous thing to name the levels of this success triangle. We'll put it that way. It's not a pyramid scheme. No. We'll have like 5 layers. How about that? And we'll like name them, or we'll have them as like different letters. So like it'll be like P O N, I don't know, Z I. We'll call it, instead of a pyramid scheme sounds gross, how about like a Ponzi scheme. No. All right, we're backtracking that real fast. That's the wonderful thing about the pyramid, the triangle of success. It's it goes back and forth. I brought in my five, so I'm good. Time Watcher, you're good. You've brought in multiple people. Pyramids do not have five layers, so it works. Well, it's like the food pyramid. You know, that has multiple layers. That's what I'm thinking. I have active right now without subbing myself. Jackie, Fredo, Ray, Jeremy, Kai, Scott, two people I watched from New World, and two people I found from Reels. And you've been gifted all of those. That is crazy. Have I been gifted anybody recently? I got one gift to Game Attack, one to a channel I've never seen in my life. Thunderstones, a few people from my Twitch team, and then like Ross from Game Grumps, Kinda Funny. A few people. They're not active right now. I haven't been watching them enough, but I enjoy getting the gifties. Biggie! Hello, my friend! What's going on, buddy? I'll wait until I've brought in the army, then I'll do the big reveal. I know you've already brought in one. Yeah, it's just have those two friends call two friends. Triangle of success. Never paid a sub to any of them? That's awesome, dude. That's so funny. I love getting gifties. It's not a pyramid scheme. It's a mutually beneficial pyramid-shaped situation. It's like you've been in a pyramid scheme. You know exactly how to word it. To just never call it a pyramid scheme. No. I think it's Nutri-something. It's one of those gross-ass green sludge drinks. I watched John Oliver's video on pyramid schemes, and I've had friends get trapped in pyramid schemes, and fuck, man. Oh, it pisses me off. But I think it was the green sludge one of many, that like there was a conference of like we're going back to just chatting. there was a conference that they were putting on for their potential sellers. You know, I don't know what they're called, but they're like, if you only have to buy $3,000 worth of product, and then you're immediately in on the iron level, and then you move up to the bronze, silver, gold level. Platinum is not the top. Platinum is like, you're finally out on your own. You're bringing in new people. And then you get the quartz level and the sapphire, this, whatever. Like, just started taking every known rock in existence. And they had, like, 17 levels before you even approached, like, the top 5%. And it's like, oh my god. I mean, I get it. My little monkey brain constantly wants to seek the next milestone. We're almost at 1,700 followers. But, like, my god. Twitch doesn't have a $3,000 buy-in. All I needed to do was buy my PC, buy my monitors, buy my games, a capture card, a microphone, a Go XLR, lighting, webcam. I gotta go. Don't talk to me right now. I need a minute. Fuck! Oh my god! Oh my god! I'm never going to financially recover from this. But yeah, fuck those pyramid schemes, am I right? I did have to buy the chair too. Oh my god, I had to buy the chair. My That's another expense. This Skyquake LLC, it's not an LLC, but this business has been operating at a loss for several years now. Welcome back, Kaiser. That does not sound fun. I hope everything's okay. What kind of business is it? Me? I am not technically registered as a, like, an LLC or anything. I'm still technically a sole proprietor when I file for taxes. I don't know if filing as an LLC will increase anything, but it's not something that I've felt I've needed to do yet. Because Twitch gives me all the tax forms that I need. I input those, input any other revenue after that. Excuse me. Deductibles like games, consoles, stream equipment, electricity bill, internet bill, stuff like that I can use as deductibles. Merchandising, marketing, networking with like subs and stuff I can write off, but I'm not technically an LLC yet. I am a sole proprietor. I do my taxes. That's what I'm saying. I pay hella taxes. I'm a good boy. I'm a good boy. I pay tax. I don't remember having that Squakebot alert pop up. Oh, Sheep did it. Thank you, Sheep. I love when ad breaks freeze the stream. Oh, did I have an ad break pop up? Oh, I don't know if this is, I didn't know if that was copyright. I was like, this isn't approved. This doesn't sound familiar. My bad. There we go. But anyway, I gotta scroll up a little bit. I feel like I've missed a couple of messages. Anyway, yeah, buy some merch. New merch shop coming, I'd say, by the end of this year, early next year. Merch drop 2.0, baby! And I will not be sunsetting any of the current products, I don't think. Everything will be on there. I don't, at least with that, merch drop one is not going to be any time kept anything. So those won't be going away, but merch drop two also won't be limited. I'm just saying, expect it end of this year, early next year. More merch. We have designs going. Emily is working hard on them. I appreciate her always. And, they're creative. I like them. Like, they are, like, elevated. They are going to be much more in-depth. I just wanted a logo and some merch and everything coming out there. And everyone who bought merch has been incredible. The reception was nothing but positive. There was just one product that one person got that had a hole in it. And I think he returned it. And then got a new one. But other than that, everything else was great. Stickers were a little small, but everything else, everyone loved it. I love my Skyquake hoodie. I wore it to my family gathering a couple of days ago. The same family that I talked a few weeks ago about, they're like, oh, how's the videos thing going? And I'm like, it's good. It's good. And they asked me again. Like, they're like, hey, how's the video game thing going? And which is a better question to ask. And I'm like, it's going really well. And I kind of talked about everything that had happened over the past 2 years that I didn't see them. And a few cousins recognized my sweatshirt saying Skyquake on it because they follow me on Instagram. They don't necessarily follow my Twitch. One was like, oh, hey, like you're wearing your own shirt. That's awesome. I'm like, yeah, I sell these and it's super cool. And my uncle was even like, hey, that's really awesome that you do that. You make some money doing it. Everyone has been like super supportive. like people that I know don't necessarily understand. They're super cool about it, and they're asking me, they're trying to understand. And even if they're not like in touch with everything that's going on, they want to know more, and they're super happy for me. And a lot of like, I had a few like aunts and uncles that I thought would make fun of me for it. Thrilled that things are going well. The I don't get it, but good for you. Yeah, exactly. And so like they'll ask questions, and I'll be like, yeah, I do this, I play this, I sell this. This is what's considered a product. This is what they are interested in. And this is what I work on when I'm not on camera. So like other videos, merch, marketing, like social media, this and that. And I say it's, I call it a side job. I call it a side business, a side gig. And they're thrilled. And I love it. That felt really good. That felt really good to have people that I thought would either like brush me off or make fun of me be like super happy for me. And they're not bad people. They just wouldn't get it. It would just be boomer jokes, you know? But I love it. I need to get something that isn't going to make me drip and sweat because of the climate over here. The hoodies are hot. The hoodies are hot. Yeah. They're good. Especially in like the cold months. Amazing. So like when merch dropped in March of this year, it was perfect sweater weather, perfect hoodie weather. It was amazing. And anytime I wore it during the summer, I was dying. My family's told me I should stream before because of my gaming expertise. I always tell them it's not that simple. No, but if it's something you're interested in, you can definitely do it. I don't know if it's something you're interested in or if you've ever done it before, Kaiser, but I think you can absolutely do it. If it's something you're interested in. Asterisk there. I don't want to be like, do it! If you're like, have zero interest. But you're right. It is not that simple. There's a lot that goes into it. But if you're just doing it as a hobby, cool. Oh, hey, this is where the unsolicited gamer streamer advice is coming into play. Neat. Tyler didn't get a hoodie? I know you got a couple of things, Tyler. Yeah, hoodie's hot. It is very insulated, but it's so comfortable. Oh my God, it's so comfortable. If I do see any DBH sales, I'll let people know in Discord because I've seen a couple of them pop up and I don't know if they would ever apply to my store, but if I do see any merch sales pop up, I will let people know. I learned that it wasn't my cup of tea, but it's fine. Worked out and Jake got an Elgato out of it. Oh, hell yeah. That's awesome. And like, that's perfectly cool. Like, if it's not your thing, it is not for everybody. And that is perfectly fine. For me, I may never push past being a 15 viewer Andy, which is fine. Fine by me. Like, would I like to elevate it more? Totally. But it's something that I like doing. And that's all that matters. And if people... If it's too much stress, people don't like being on camera, there's too much to juggle, not enough time, not the right equipment. There's so many things that go into it where it's like, it's perfectly understandable. And that's for anybody. I'm not just talking about one person in particular. Yeah, streaming is fun. Because I've always liked making people laugh. I'm no stand-up comedian. No, I prefer sitting down. I prefer sitting down. Ha ha ha. Anyway. I like making people laugh. It's fun. And if I can play video games while I'm doing it, fine by me. That is the best of both worlds. A wise person once said that. You get the best of both worlds. I'm content being the weirdo who frequents people's chats. I could realistically only see myself streaming if it was to show a friend something and I can't screen share it. That's fair. That's the big thing, as Andrea's well aware, I'm very cagey when it comes to my face. Known her 3+ years, she still doesn't know what I look like. And that's another thing, and that's why I wanted to say that. If people are uncomfortable on camera, they don't like their voice. I don't like listening back to my voice, but I do it because I know I don't have the worst voice. I know my voice is a little flat, so I'm no singer. I only got those golden pipes, but you know, I'm a little self-conscious about that. But there are some people who genuinely don't want to show their face, have people hear their voice. They're too shy for this or that, and that's completely fine, completely understandable. And that's why I wanted to include that too. There's a lot of reasons why people wouldn't want to stream. Hannah Montana was beyond her time, wise beyond her years. Same could be said about me for Squake. Yes, I have never seen Time Watcher's face, and he has told me his name once. I forgot, and he will not tell me again. Refuses to tell me again. So I just call him Timothy. I loathe my voice. You don't have a bad voice. If someone else had my voice, I'd be so annoyed and not like them. No. I mean, I can't tell you to not feel that way, but you are making it sound much worse than it is. Your voice is perfectly fine. I hated my voice until I started making music, and now I really don't mind it. That's great. That's fantastic. And again, I've kind of gotten over like listening to my own voice. Although I work a phone job, I'm on the phones at my job for my school, and my boss will make me listen to my own calls, and I want to off myself because I hate it. Because it also sounds like awful quality. But then like once I'm actually into it, or once I'm watching a VOD, once I'm listening to a call, it's really not bad. I just need to get over that hump. I did tell you again and you forgot it a second time. No, you didn't. No, you've tried giving me hints and you have never told me a second time. I just constantly sound like I'm on the verge of laughing at something. Maybe it's just because we're always like laughing when we're like talking, but like I've never picked up on that. And that's another thing, that like everyone is their harshest critic. Everyone. Andrea is the only person in the greater Storm community who knows my full name. A few know my first name. It's Kaiser, obviously. I did ask people when I first started streaming. I'm like, oh, hey, DP777, do you have a name on your birth certificate that's not DP777? And I feel like that got weird, but like some people were like, oh, that's an interesting way to get to know me. But others were like, no, I don't. I'm like, all right, I'm not gonna start asking people for their real names. No, thank you. Used to make editing hard. Oh my god, the first few videos that I listened to or that I worked on, and including the Pokemon video right now, after hearing the same voice clip 20, 30, 40 times, trying to get the timing right, the edits right, whatever, oh my god, it makes me want to quit working on the video. Maybe it's just what I hear when I watch back any VODs I was in or anything. Yeah, it's not bad. I love when people call me Sheep. It's so funny to me. So, Sheep, I gotta ask, is your name Sean? Because there's like a 50-50 shot that it's not. Because it's just Sean the Sheep. That's a thing. It is. Oh, okay. Yeah. Meanwhile, on Discord, I'm just Dave and have my regular profile picture. And I mean, like, I was Nick for a while. Everyone knows I'm Nick. And, like, I don't care if people call me Nick, Sky, Skyquake, Squakey Poo. Tyler! I don't have merch alerts on any other scene. Tyler, thank you so much for buying a hoodie. Good choice. Good choice, my friend. I like it. I love it. I don't know why I don't have alert merches. Merch alerts. Anywhere else, I'll have to fix that. So thank you for reminding me. Meanwhile, oh wait. Ray and Rhi are so close together, so I just naturally respond to either. It's funny. Me and Dave have talked about this, where whenever we find out someone's real name in chat, it's hard for us to call them their screen name, or we're torn on what we want to do. And so, like, Raven, I know you. We've met. I know your name. But I never know what you'd prefer or what other people would prefer if I know both of your names. So, like, Polite. Polite's a good friend of mine. Like, I'd like to think so anyway. He might hate me. He might, you know, can't stand me, throw me to the curb. But, you know, I know him as Sean. And other people call him Polite. Other people call him Sean. And so I mix between the two. And like, he calls me Squake, he calls me Nick, whatever it is, because we're good, we're chill. And so I sometimes struggle when it comes to anybody. Raven, now Sheep, you know. I don't mind either, but it's nice hearing Ray, since Ree I hear more. You like Ray? That's all I needed to hear. Oh, Raven, you did say something earlier that I meant to respond to, but I forgot. It was who you've brought into the channel, and it made, like, I laughed in my head, but I was talking about something else. You said that you brought in Tub, Goblin, Suze, I forgot about Suze, Meow, who's inactive, Shania, who's inactive, and Does My Grandma Count? She periodically asks about you. That's so funny. And anytime we think about, like, when we met up in Portland, I'm like, oh yeah, I met Ray and her mom and her grandma, who were both awesome. They were so nice. And I think about that anytime I wear my Drink Wisconsinly shirt that you got me, which I still wear. I wore it last week. I actually had someone stop me. I think it was in a restaurant or something. They saw my Drink Wisconsinly shirt and they're like, oh, hey, you from Wisconsin? I'm like, no. They're like, okay. Ended the conversation real quick. Since there's already a Sean, Sheep is preferable. Oh no, anything is fine. I mean, there can be multiple Seans. And just because there's one Sean doesn't mean all other Seans have to figure something else out. It's always weird. It always weirds me out when people I know on the internet call me my real name. That's why I ask people to not use it if they know. You will be Kaiser. My grandma isn't that cool. Neither is mine. She doesn't talk much. She's dead. Anyway. No, I haven't heard any complaints out of her in a while. It's like when I was learning how to drive in early high school, my parents took me to a cemetery because they're very straight roads. If it's like a big cemetery, very straight roads, just a few turns here and there. And every time they're like, hey, yeah, we can practice driving here. You won't hear any complaints. No one's going to say anything to you. You're not disturbing anybody. Now for the reveal that my name isn't actually Tyler. If you tell me that your name isn't actually Tyler and that the past 4.5 years has been a lie, I'm gonna lose my shit. I would clip that, but I'm not sure if that's one you want free floating. If I said something that I didn't mean and I really regretted it, I would end stream and delete the VOD. So no, don't worry about it. I got no regrets. And worst case scenario, I... And you go home, go to bed, and hear in your sleep you left your blinker on, dumbass. That's why my house is haunted. They're pissed that I drove on the grass. Tyler, that'd be hilarious. That'd be so fucking funny. Oh my god. I read this in the voice of the dad from That 70s Show. Red Foreman? Dad of the year? That Red Foreman? That they're apparently making a spin-off show of called That 90s Show with Kitty and Red? I mean, we already tried That 80s Show. Yeah, you want to know why we're going to That 90s Show? There's a reason. It's because we did That 80s Show. Who remembers that? Oh, you don't? Huh. That's weird. You know I'm bringing this up. And, who knows who was in the cast of That 80s Show? Don't answer that. I'll tell you. Where is it showing up? Ha ha! That's right. Oh. This is not working out. I shouldn't have done this. Oh my god, I'm the worst. Dennis! From freaking It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia was the main guy on That 80s Show. Fucking Dennis. And then these four nobodies. God. Who hired this clown? Let's see how long that show lasted. Ah, one season, 13 episodes. Surprisingly, went from January to May. So it sounds like it played start to finish. I only learned it was Glenn Howerton very recently. I've known that for a while, but I also had like no investment in Glenn Howard. Oh my god. Yeah, I've made a mistake. That was not forwarding. Formatted correctly. Yeah, goddamn. Apparently it was just awful. I think I watched the first half of the first episode on YouTube and it is not fucking good. I hope that it works well. Especially with Red and Kitty in it. But I know the last season of That 70s Show sucked ass without Topher Grace. They brought not Seth Meyers into it. And so, yeah, we'll see. Like, within the last week? Oh, my God. Yeah. Garbage. Garbage show. I hope That 90s Show does it justice, but also I'm not optimistic. Every like reboot that has come out recently doesn't look great. If I'm also mostly thinking about like 90s shows, if we want to think about that, Boy Meets World came out with Girl Meets World, and I watched the first few episodes and oh my god. I loved Boy Meets World. Loved it. One of my favorite shows of the 90s. Adored it. I wanted to gouge my eyes out. It was so bad. Apparently, That's a Raven. More of a 2000s show. Just got a reboot. And I don't know if that's still going on. Fuller House. Fuller House was the cheesiest shit. And I know that Full House was cheesy. I know it had those 90s sitcom, a very special episode moments. Excuse me. Wow, Fuller House sucked ass. How that got five seasons? No clue. No clue. So yeah, I'm not optimistic. I would love to be proven wrong. Please prove me wrong. Didn't help that the whole season had big Hafe Forget the main character. He's New Guy. Everyone loves New Guy. Yeah. Yeah, it's not Seth Meyers. He's got nice hair. He's handsome. He's dating Donna. He's basically the same character as Eric. I look forward to the next decade when they decide to reboot Scrubs. Oh, Dave has entered the chat. Dave, how do you feel about season 9 of Scrubs? Did you hear all about the hilarity that live-action Powerpuff Girls gritty CW reboot they were going to do? Is it still in production? Because I know they lost one Powerpuff Girl. I don't know if they lost two. But I heard it's just been a dumpster fire. Same with Batwoman. Batwoman has just been all over the place. Have you seen the fucking costumes for that? I don't remember. I also remember we laughed at the costumes for Titans. And apparently Titans is pretty good. I have to talk about the acid trip. That was 2000's animated series because it's my favorite. I haven't talked about the acid trip that was 2000's animated series because it's my favorite. So, like, what in particular? Literally, the only CW show I've heard even remotely good things about has been Superman and Lois. Oh, I haven't heard much about that. Contrary to literally everyone else, I didn't think season 9 would have been hated if it had a different name. It wasn't a bad show. It was a bad season of Scrubs. That's a really good way of thinking about it. I have not seen much of season 9. What I did see, I did not like. But I feel like that's also how some people would view, like, some game series. So, like, I remember people saying that Call of Duty World War II, not Vanguard, but World War II, would have been a good World War II game, but it's a bad Call of Duty game. And so it's interesting to think about it that way. That it, like, if the title was different, would it have been viewed differently? Arrow started good, but just declined over time. Dave has entered the chat. Dave is our resident CW expert. Seen almost every show. I'm pretty sure it's just no Supergirl and Black Lightning. Think back to any animated show from 90s to 2000s, and it's almost all complete chaos and nonsense. First three that come to mind: Angry Beavers, Rocko's Modern Life, Ren and Stimpy. Insane. First two seasons of Arrow were top tier. Yes. I talk about this with Dave all the time. Like, that's why I say he's the CW expert. We talk about this all the time. First two seasons of Arrow, fantastic. First two seasons of Flash, amazing. Season three of Flash, couldn't get through. First four episodes of season three of Arrow made me stop completely. Couldn't do it. Ooh, Banjo-Kazooie, Nuts and Bolts. That game does not look good. I'm not super well-versed in CW outside of Arrow, Flash, Legends, and Supernatural. I gotta watch Supernatural. I got through the first season and then watched it with a girlfriend in high school, and she liked it a little too much, which made me not like it. Same with Jenna Marbles. She liked Jenna Marbles a little too much, which made me not like Jenna Marbles for a long time. She was crazy. Maybe I'll delete the VOD. with that... I gotta watch more Supernatural because that shit's so good. You have four seasons left? That's not bad. Yeah, Supernatural has like 17 seasons? 16 or 17. Supernatural is one of my comfort shows with The Office, but holy crap, they should have ended the show sooner. I feel like that's what The Flash is right now. They should have ended that after like five seasons. I actually was on Facebook earlier. I don't use Facebook that often. I just doom scroll through Twitter and Facebook. And a link came up for all of the Flash villains ranked based on like how good they were and how bad they were, whatever. And it was like a top 9 list. Like, there have been like 8 or 9 like main villains in the Flash. And I was scrolling through, just looking at names and not descriptions to, like, spoil myself. If, for whatever reason, I jump back in, And so I saw, like, The Thinker, Godspeed, whoever. And I'm like, I don't recognize any of these names. So these are all seasons I haven't watched. And I've only seen seasons 1 through 3. And I know a little bit about 4. And so I jump through the list and I'm like, okay, I'm sensing a pattern here. And so the top three villains were season 3, season 2, and then season 1. And so I'm like, okay, what you're telling me is it has been a constant decline since season 1 of The Flash of how good the villains are. Where they started off with the best villain, they got the second best villain, the third best villain, and it has never, ever lived up to that sense. Cool. Flash isn't as bad as everyone says it is now, but it definitely has a lot more weak episodes than I would like. And I loved season 1. Oh my god, I loved season 1 so much. And like, maybe if I have nothing else to watch, I'll go back. It is definitely not on one of my like shit lists of like, oh, I'll never go back to The Flash. But yeah, it's a shame that it never lived up to season 1 and 2. That's really what it is. I've had the feeling about Dark Souls 2, actually, wait. I've been quite vocal about my distaste for it, but if it wasn't made by FromSoft, I'd praise it as one of the best Souls-likes out there. I have heard discourse about Dark Souls 2. Supernatural should have ended after season 5. That is a bold take. This is the first time I'm watching Supernatural in order. It was my dad's show when episodes were coming out and he'd watch some without me. Then I watched it on my own. I just pick random episodes because I knew the general plot. Yeah, I feel like I jumped into Supernatural on like random episodes here and there. So like I watched like the Bloody Mary episode, which was season 1. I watched this and that here and there as like my girlfriend at the time was watching them, but never consistently. And then I started watching season 1 and 2 consistently. I'm like, this shit's real good. I tried watching The Flash, but I had to like just finish forcing myself through season 3 of Arrow and probably didn't give it a fair shake. Maybe that's where I'm at too, where like I'm like 3 episodes away from finishing season 3 of The Flash. Just figured out like the true identity of the villain in season 3, Savitar. Like figured out who was behind Savitar, and then I stopped. Just couldn't do it. I don't know why. So maybe I'll finish season 3, maybe that'll jumpstart my interest in season 4, but like the grittiness of Arrow season 1 and 2 hooked the shit out of me. Like Deathstroke, oh my god, love Deathstroke. He was season 2, right? Yeah, because he got like locked in the bunker in season 2, and then whatever it was, like Roy is a whiny bitch, and then it just like focused a lot on Felicity. Even for season 3, and I know that's not the worst of it. Trust me, I know. But yeah, season 3, I couldn't do it. The Flash has been dragged on for a bit too long, and it's not that terrible. Yeah, no. It doesn't seem that terrible. It seems cheesy. It seems like they're adding too many supers. Or what are they called? What are they called? Not mutants, not supers. Metas? Yeah, I think they're called metas. I will stand by the fact that Arrow, The Flash, whatever, lost its like magic when they added magic. So like when they really started adding a new like magical element rather than just like, oh, this person has this power because of the explosion that we have to take down for like all of season 1. I didn't care that there was a new meta every episode for The Flash, but it was when they just started adding the Speed Force and different worlds. And I know that's what the comics are. This is just me saying that it brought me out of it, but I liked the grittiness of like Arrow season 1 leaning into season 2. Of like, this sounds like it could genuinely happen. Like, or this is real world shit. Like, these are real people, not aliens, not mutants, not whatever. That's why I loved the beginning of Arrow. But then the crossovers were obviously bound to happen. They're superheroes. It's going to happen. But like, I liked the more grounded, kind of darker stuff of those first few seasons of those shows. Supernatural has like the anime thing where each like big baddie is stronger than the last, and the main characters have plot armor and get special powers or weapons or whatever. Like, how many times has Dean died? 17? 20? Who's to say? You can introduce nutso shit like the Speed Force without it throwing you out. You just have to do it properly. CW, broadly speaking, isn't good at subtle writing. The big problem with Arrow Season 5 is probably the best season. Wait, the big problem with Arrow is Season 5 was probably the best season. 7 took a goddamn nosedive into barely watchable territory. 1, 2, 5, 8 were incredible. 3 and 4 were okay. 6 was meh, but more bad than good. 7 is crap. And that's when the subreddit for Arrow turned to a Daredevil subreddit. They revolted. Went from a Green Arrow subreddit to Daredevil, I believe, because they're like, fuck this, done, can't do it anymore. It's like when Pro Jared got Me Too'd into oblivion and his subreddit got turned into a Scott the Waz subreddit, right? It's just like, yeah, fuck this, I'm out. And I believe that's probably what's going to happen to Gus Johnson, too. Like, everyone left the Gus Johnson subreddit. Who is of right mind. Otherwise, it's just the shitty-ass defenders who are going to defend shitty people for life. Whew. Remember when we were going to play video game? What happened with him? Oh. Gus Johnson's not a great person. It's tough, but basically his ex-girlfriend, Sabrina, when they were a fairly new couple, had an ectopic pregnancy, which like can risk your life or kill you. And he said something along the lines of, anyone else would have left you by now if this happened to you, or if this happened to them. And then she had to recover from that, was not present, was not supportive. She just got like rhinoplasty, like got a nose job for whatever reason. I don't know if it was cosmetic or a medical issue, but as she was recovering, he was just streaming opening Pokemon cards and was like, oh, if you need any help, you let me know. I'm one text away. I'm going to be in the other room, okay? And she's like in agony, in pain, texts him like, hey, are you wrapping up stream soon? I need some help. And he texts back, like, he looks at his phone on stream, puts it down, keeps opening packs. And then at one point responded like, oh, I have like 10 more packs. I'm on a roll. It's an obligation at this point. To open more Pokemon packs while your girlfriend is suffering in the other room? Fuck off. And like, she announced all of this in a video, which is super brave, super strong of her. And then he basically confirmed it. And was like, yeah, I was shitty, but I've grown since then. Which means he's probably only referencing the pregnancy, the ectopic pregnancy, and not anything that happened 3 weeks before. So, goodbye, Gus. That sounds like 3 years of being shitty and not being present and being selfish. So, Gus, I love you. Loved you, but nope. That sucks. I've heard about the Jared thing. Apparently, he had receipts that disprove most of the shitty allegations, which is something at least. Well, I know that, he was still like, there were receipts on both ends, and I haven't kept up with it since like the initial push of everything like that with Jared. But I know that there was like a lot of backlash to the ex-girlfriend or the ex-wife, but she had legitimate receipts that he was cheating. But also, I know that people have like kind of gone back to him because they're like, he had proof that not everything he did was bullshit. And so again, I know less about that. And so I'm not going to speak as fact on that. But yeah. Last I saw, what he did was weird, but not illegal or shady. We are referencing Pro Jared. I've seen his penis. Wanna know who else I've seen? Adam fucking Kovic. God, that was gross. Adam Kovic just came back. He is doing a thing with Aaron Marquis. He came back after a year of getting booted from Rooster Teeth. I've seen those pictures. That was gross. The stream is now about how many penises Squake has seen. Penises of popular YouTubers. The fact that the answer is more than zero makes me uncomfortable. Let's go back to Arrow. Dave said season 4 would have been bad, but Neil McDonough, I don't know how to pronounce his name. Damien Dark was so goddamn good that he carried it, and they kept finding reasons to keep him around well past when it makes any sense, but he was too good to get rid of. I love Neil McDonough in everything that he's in. I remember he was the bad guy in Walking Tall, that shitty ass remake of Walking Tall starring The Rock. That was like the best shit when I was fucking 12. I thought that was the coolest. And he was the villain in that, but man, looking back, that movie was not great. You've seen more famous penises than I have, that's for sure. I'm not flexing here. I try my best to not even look at the drama on the internet. You are better off. Walking Tall was great. Again, him carrying the 2x4, badass. With a great villain. It's not the worst movie. What does it have on Rotten Tomatoes? And I think they were making... I think Walking Tall has been remade 2 or 3 times, and if not, they're making a 3rd or a 4th. Okay. Walking Tall has a 26% on Rotten Tomatoes, and then they made a sequel called Walking Tall: The Payback with fucking Kevin Sorbo. Fucking Kevin Sorbo. You know, him as, what was he, Hercules? And also just like a stupid fucking right-wing quack who's pushing anti-vax propaganda. Okay. I remember there was like fucking, it must have been a couple of months ago that Kevin Sorbo, Dean Cain, Rob Schneider, and like one other guy just all decided to just out themselves as like people who don't know what the fuck they're talking about. He is a hyper religious nut job, Dave. He is. So all 4 of those people, or 3 or 4 of those people, decided they were going to be the voice of reason. And so I decided to look up why they have this credibility. Why we should listen to Kevin Sorbo and Rob Schneider and Dean Cain for our voice of scientific research. And then I saw Kevin Sorbo in Pool Boy, drowning out the fury. Right? Yeah. That's the voice of scientific research right there. We look up Rob Schneider. I mean, this kind of speaks for itself. Hot chick, Deuce Bigelow. Look, yeah. It's a character, but you know, yeah, this is not great. The one that really hit me, and oh, God's not dead. Oh, was he in God's Not Dead? Experience the number one Christian movie in America. Can I be honest with you? Can I be honest? I have never looked into God's Not Dead, but for whatever reason, these posters made me think this was a horror movie. Is that fucked up? Like... Wait, I remember seeing the ads for that movie, God's Not Dead, and it was so funny, I thought it had to be a parody. Then when I realized they were serious, I got sad. I have never seen a trailer for this. I just thought that based on these pictures, for whatever reason, it looked gritty. It looked whatever. I'm like, these must be like zombie movies or like horror movies, whatever it was. I don't know why. Clearly, based on a picture like this, oh yeah. One of what screams Jesus? The Washington Monument. Please watch the trailer for the first one sometime. Incredible if you think of it like an SNL parody. I won't get in trouble for watching a trailer on stream, right? It's movie night.
Prayed and believed your whole life.
Dean Cain!
And here you are. Explain that to me.
What do you say to people that are offended by your show because you pray to Jesus in every episode?
Is that
we disown him?
From Duck Dynasty?
When a 12-year-old watches his mother dying of cancer, a God who would allow that is not worth believing in. Life is really a tale told by an idiot full of sound and fury and signifying nothing.
Name? Wheaton. Josh Wheaton. Philosophy 150.
You might want to think about a different instructor.
Come on, man. It can't be that bad.
Think Roman Coliseum. People cheering for your death.
I'm Professor Radisson. This is Philosophy 150. I would like to bypass senseless debate altogether and jump to the conclusion, which every sophomore is already aware of, there is no God. All that I require from each of you is that you fill in the papers I've just given you with three little words. God is dead.
I've had instructors like this.
The Wheaton is something wrong.
I can't do what you want. I'm a Christian.
If you cannot bring yourself to admit that God is dead, then you will need to defend the antithesis.
Think of Jesus as my friend.
You think Jesus is God?
I don't want to disappoint him. So your acceptance of this challenge may be the only meaningful exposure to God and Jesus they'll ever have.
See, to me, he's not dead. I don't want anyone to get talked out of believing in him just because his professor thinks they should.
Mr. Wheaton, are you ready?
We're going to put God on trial.
Do you think you're smarter?
Oh my God!
Do not try to humiliate me in front of my students. In that classroom, there is a God. I am.
This experiment
on
is
trial.
Over. You should decide who the most important person in your life is. Me, Professor Radisson.
But I have to do this thing. Like it's something that God wants me to do. I can't just turn away from it.
You just want to ensnare them in your primitive superstition.
What I want is for them to make their own choice. That's what God wants.
You have no idea how much I'm going to enjoy failing you.
Yeah, but who are you really looking to fail? Me? Or God.
I knew he was gonna say it.
God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead, surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion.
Science supports his existence. You know the truth. So why do you hate him? It's a very simple question. Why do you hate God?
God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside.
Oh my God. The fucking burst of Christian rock just fucking smacked me across the face. Oh my God. Wow. And what does this have on Rotten Tomatoes? It's a 12. Why is that a good idea? Time, I see your question and I will raise you a second question. Why are there three? Why are there three? And also, is God's Not Dead, We the People number four? Uploaded on July 13th, 2021. And that's not Kevin Sorbo.
Freedom is a fragile thing.
We're not watching this whole thing.
And it's never more than one generation away from extinction.
That's 2 million views.
And those in world history who have known freedom and then lost it have never known it again.
Let's face it, your God, your book, they're in the way. You feel that you're making a last-ditch stand for your faith, and you've chosen this as a hill that you're willing to die on.
Oh, the other person was James Woods.
Because one man chose a hill he was willing to die on.
I would like to call this hearing of the House Subcommittee to order.
Right now, there's an effort on the way to mandate universal educational guidelines.
Once we decide what a child needs to know, it becomes imperative that every child...
Is God on trial again?
Remember the visit we got from social services the other day?
Is God's case moved up to the Supreme Court? Did it leave local jurisdiction and move its way up? God.
I'm here to review your homeschooling environment.
Religion has been removed from our schools. They're teaching kids that they don't need God.
If your children do not show up at school a week from Monday, you will...
Jeanine Pirro. They got fucking Jeanine... Jeanine Pirro? You can hire any actress to be a female judge. You don't need to get... A crazy ass. All right.
Charged with contempt of court.
They're like,
meaning you will be incarcerated.
We have to get an actual judge. Is she an actual judge? I don't know. We'll get her.
This is bigger than just homeschooling. I think we should fight this. We need to.
Just want to make sure you understand what you're fighting here.
Our district teaches a revisionist version of history.
If God is for us, who can be against us?
Not around here. Just about everyone else.
The country is just now beginning to realize that unity means winning under our terms.
The soundtrack kind of slaps, though.
Trying to get rid of Christianity. What makes you think that you can accomplish what they couldn't?
They didn't have an 83% approval rating.
That's part of your plan, isn't it? Keep us all divided so we don't realize that you're really chipping
away.
They
use the same song in four movies.
America is a country so blessed, to whom much is given, much will be required.
You see those statues and those monuments out there? They say, you work for us.
You are out of order, Mr. Hill.
A government of the people, by the people, for the people.
Yeah. God's not dead. He just hates you. Oh, wow. Oh, my God. No.
Freedom is a fragile thing.
Get out of here. Get out of here. God's not dead. Is this out yet? I didn't pay attention to the release date. October 4th. Movie night? Anyway. Whew, that Kevin Sorbo, Dean Cain, 1-2. Man, that got me good. Whew. Anyway. What I was gonna say... You see what 2, 3, and 4 have? So, we don't have a count for God's Not Dead, We the People. Wait, God's Not Dead 5? Okay. Wait, God's Not Dead, We the People isn't number 3? Or number 4? God's Not Dead 2 has a 10%. It's a 10. God's Not Dead 3? That has a 10%. God's Not Dead 4. Oh, that is We the People. Okay. The fourth installment in the God's Not Dead series, it was released on October 4th in a 3-night theatrical engagement. What does that mean? What does that mean? What's a 3-night theatrical engagement? Time, that's a really good point that my search history is fucked now. Wanna know why? I, from experience, one movie ruined the show. I will get back to the Wacko Bongo Republicans spreading anti-vax nonsense in a second. The one movie that destroyed my search history. ...2018's Little Italy. Hayden Christensen and Emma Roberts. I searched this movie once. What? I searched this movie once. And my phone gave me push notifications on when Little Italy came to DVD and Blu-ray, when it came to streaming services, when reviews were posted on obscure websites. Months. Look at Dead Eyes Hayden Christensen here. Oh my God. He looks like he's 50. And like he doesn't look bad in real life, but whatever reason, this bad, bad movie just did not do him any favors. Oh my God, Little Italy fucked my search history up. And it's, do we know what this movie is about? It is a retelling of Romeo and Juliet, but these two lovebirds here, wrong hand, these two lovebirds are from opposing pizza shops, opposing family pizza shops, and oh man, they are competitors. They do not get along, so their love is forbidden. No. No extra sausage on her pizza. Ruined my recommendations for movies, for advertisements, everything. For so long. But back to the original point. Our man of the hour, Kevin Sorbo. Move over, Paul Rudd, sexiest man alive. Kevin Sorbo, Dean Cain, James Woods, Rob Schneider, and... Fuck. Angelina Jolie's dad. John Voight. Oh, John Voight is a lunatic. But for whatever reason, the five of them all just like came together one week, like 4 or 5 months ago. And they were like, oh yeah, today's the day that I speak up and start spreading anti-vax misinformation. Misinformation on the vaccine. They are anti-vax. Didn't want a double negative to confuse anybody. These guys are whack jobs. And so when I said before that I was looking to see their how these are reputable sources, why I should listen to this D-list celebrity give me scientific information. I found Kevin Sorbo in The Pool Boy, and also apparently God's Not Dead. We saw Rob Schneider in everything that we just saw him in. There was John Voight, who is just... The videos he posts on Twitter, you can just watch those and immediately just want to turn inside out. It's disgusting. But Dean Cain. Why do I focus on Dean Cain? This is being dragged on too long, so I'm just going to bring up... Dean Cain and Tara Reid in Andy the Talking Hedgehog. He seems trustworthy to me. Andy the Talking Hedgehog. Every single promotional poster. Oh, this is just a YouTube thumbnail. Every picture you click, it gets worse. Oh my God, the hedgehog is riding a horse. Do you see that creepy ass smile? Look at its teeth. No, that's not what I wanted. I wanted open image in a new tab.
Oh, hi. Thanks for checking in. I'm still a piece of garbage.
Exact. I love you. I'm so sorry that you're coming in to this. Exact, thank you so much for the 33 months, especially using the Prime. I appreciate that. Raven, did I thanked you for the 47, right? I know I just talked about your name being long. Thank you for the 47 months. Exact, thank you for the Prime for 33 months. I appreciate both of you. I appreciate you, Exact. 33 months is a long time. I'm just gonna just... Look at the teeth on Andy, the hedgehog that is talking. Christ. This is someone who is talking about the woke mob and cancel culture is ruining everything and you can't say anything anymore because the damn sensitive liberal. Oh my God. I wouldn't take a movie gig in a movie called Andy the Talking Hedgehog. This man was fucking Superman. But it's a magical good time. But yeah, look at it. It's riding a fucking horse. But I can see why they really wanted to... Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, this is the best thing I've ever seen. They really wanted to lean into the... straight to DVD... the fad. Including Arlo the Burping Pig. Rodeo Girl. With Kevin Sorbo. Horse Camp with Dean Cain. Amanda and the Fox with... I can't read any of those names. But Dean Cain, you... Oh, you crazy son of a bitch. You've done it again. You've struck gold. Dean, do home runs stop being fun after the 1,000th? Or do you just keep doing it for the thrill of it? You gotta give us your secret. Just... Hit it home. Let us know how it goes. Don't listen to celebrities giving scientific advice on vaccines. Get the vaccine. Did all of these have the same graphic designer? Look at them all. I'm gonna head to bed so I don't die tomorrow. Later, nerds. Later, Raven. Thank you so much for stopping by, saying hello. Hope you have a good rest of your night. We gotta look up Arlo the Burping Pig now. Oh my God. These people were never in the same room together. Joey Lawrence and the voice of Drake Bell. Before Drake Bell was caught for sexual misconduct, one of the last things he did was voice Arlo the burping pig. Oh my God. Why do comedians write their own jokes when this shit writes itself? The voice of Drake Bell. I love it. I love it. Oh, and then there's the amazing burping pig. Oh, there was a sequel. Wow. Ooh. I love it here. Oh God. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, I hate it. Yeah. Brandino. What's up, buddy? Hope you're doing well. What is up, my friend? Been saying it for years. Celebrities are, generally speaking, not smart people. Not a left or right thing. It's a law of the universe. It's fine if you want to make it not a left or right thing. I will gladly make it not a left or make it a left or right thing. But yeah, don't trust celebrities. Just in general, blanket statement. Don't listen to celebrities. The sequel used the same pig image. I'm wondering, maybe give it the benefit of the doubt that that it was just called something different, but ooh, man. I've seen no shortage of stupid left-wing celebrities. Politics do not make people smart. All right, I think we're drawing, like, yeah, you're right. That's why the blanket statement comes into play. Can we trust Skyquake? No. An hour ago, I tried recruiting all of you into a success pyramid structured success plan. A success triangles operation. It's just in this shape. That's all. No, don't trust me. God. I think the sequel came out a year where they could no longer use the voice of Drake Bell. No, I wish. Boy, I wish you were right. Exact. You are giving them too much credit because it features the voice of Drake Bell. We gotta look up the amazing burping pig. Oh. Not even a Rotten Tomato score. So is there, there's Arlo, oh, the amazing burping pig and Arlo the burping pig are the same thing. Okay. Oh, Joey Lawrence. No! Jonathan Lipnicki was in it? The kid from Stuart Little was in Arlo the Burping Pig? Yo, man, I'm glad I'm not an actor. Because I would hate to take roles like that. Good Lord. Oh, buddy. Oh, no. As fun as this chaos has been, I have a 6:45 a.m. alarm looking closer and closer, so I'm going to pounce. Enjoy the madness, everyone. Dave, I thought you were up because you didn't have work tomorrow. Why do you have a 6:45 alarm and you're still up? Answer me in the morning. Have a good night, buddy. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Brandino, movie night with the boys? No. Because I tried pitching a movie night for God's Not Dead, God's Not Dead 2, God's Not Dead 3, and God's Not Dead We the People. And weirdly enough, that got shut down. I very much have work tomorrow. All right, I'll talk to you later, buddy. Sometimes you take a role because you need money. Sometimes you know you're going to be in a piece of history. Like that one guy from The Room, you put respect on Tommy Wiseau's name. Why do I relate to this so hard? God, this has been insane. Remember when this was a Metroid stream? We're not playing Metroid tonight, by the way. It's not happening. Because I was going to beat Metroid tonight, but the answer is no. Because it is almost 1 a.m. I hate it here. Not the fact that we didn't play Metroid, but the fact that we had to subject ourselves to that. Again, I swear, the God's Not Dead movie poster looked like a horror poster from like 28 days later or something. Literally slept at 1 a.m., woke up at 5:30. So yeah, I don't know where all my energy is coming from. I slept in today. So I'm good, but I'm getting tired and hungry. And so I also started later than I thought I would. So yeah. My God. This has been fun. Have you watched any of them? Sir, they're so weird. I have not. I didn't know they existed or that they were actually like Christian movies until about 20 minutes ago. Because again, like I was saying, I thought the movie posters looked like they were like horror posters or something like that. And we just watched the trailer for the first one. The rabbit hole of Christian movies is fantastic. Oh, I'm trying to think of other... There was one Christian movie trailer that I saw a couple of months ago. That was just like the craziest shit. What was it? I don't know. It was insane though. I've actually been spared of VeggieTales. I have never watched VeggieTales. By the time that I was like a little older, like, I don't know when VeggieTales came out, but whatever it is, I missed the boat. One, because I was just a little bit older. And two, by the time I realized kind of like what like religion was, and like I would go to like CCD and like religion classes and stuff like that, I did not care at all. It's not Christian, but it's the same energy. Y'all remember the one about the boy who grew out of a vegetable patch? Timothy Green? Oof. Yeah, no, I missed that boat. One thing that I did find in a Walmart that was the greatest thing I've ever seen. I promise. It was amazing. I think I've shown this on stream before. I don't know if I've done it in the past like year or so. I probably have. I found a book. You could say it was the good book, right? Like the book. We all know what I'm talking about. The Action Bible. A visual, a graphic novel version of the Bible. I held this in my hands. I bought a copy for my cousin who I sent a picture of it to him in high school. He's like, I must have it. He's not a religious freak, quite the opposite. But this was just so incredible. It is a comic book version of the Bible, and they have different lessons. That's how the chapters are broken up. And I swear, none of it made sense. There was I wish I could find a picture of it. So like this is kind of what it looked like. Like it leans into the comic book style, but there was one chapter specifically called Why Do Bad Things Happen to Good People? I will never forget that headline. And me genuinely standing in a Walmart reading that chapter of the Action Bible called Why Do Bad Things Happen to Good People? It was 2 pages of pictures. And the story basically went, a man goes down to the river, th- fails to catch a fish, wonders why. That's not a bad thing. Like, it was like, he catches a fish, or he fails to catch a fish. His buddy comes over and was like, you know, like, fishing's tough. And that's it. It didn't answer, why do bad things happen to good people? I promise you, it had no resolution. It was just basically, man goes down to the river, can't catch a fish. Next chapter. Done. It's amazing. The Action Bible New Testament. They came out with a sequel. Oh my God. Maybe I can look it up. No. This has to have the Action Bible in it. I don't think we're gonna find it. Yeah, no, we're not gonna see it. But that was absolutely one of the chapters. Oh my God. I love it. I love it. Dude, fishing is life, bro. Don't diss my fishing, bro. Yeah, oh, bro, I'm sorry, bro. I'd wager the sentiment is without struggle, there's no growth, but damn boy, that is not how you portray that. Kaiser, I really appreciate that you're trying to give it credit. It was so much less clear than that. It was, again, two pages of man goes down to river, fishes, does not have anything. No resolution. You're right. I wish that I could give it some benefit of the doubt of like, oh, I can kind of see where they're going. It was basically a completely different comic. To be fair to the Action Bible, the normal Bible wasn't very coherent either. True. And much less interesting. Now that is interesting. Also, I don't really understand how it was action. Because it was basically just telling the stories. There were no guns. Why would I buy it if there were no guns? Maybe that's in the New Testament. Maybe they patched that in. Listen to fan feedback. Fan feedback about the previous Action Bible. They're like, all right, when we write the New Testament, we gotta make sure we satisfy that. More guns. More guns in the Bible. If Jesus doesn't go Mortal Kombat and start ripping out spines, you're not getting my $13.99. Yeah, obviously need guns in the New Testament. Obviously. How many people have I offended tonight? Explosions! Yes! Oh my God, how can we rewrite the New Testament? So here's what we do. Here's what we do. We take all of the current copies of the Action Bible. We'll call it the Old Testament or something. I don't know. It's just a name I came up with. And then we light them on fire. All right. We light them on. Right? Yes? Who's on board? Show of hands. This guy. I'm not seeing enough raised hands. We'll just replace him with copies of Fahrenheit 451. Get it? Because it's about burning books. There we go. A not so enthusiastic hands up. I see nothing but profit here. Yeah. It's something people care about and they'll pay money for. Why do you think when you go to church, they hand out those baskets for you to just put cash in? That's not going to the church. That's their PS5 fund. Father Fitzgerald needs a new PS5, baby. They know what they're doing. He just needs to pray he gets one. Oh! He needs to pray to get one. Oh, man. It doesn't work. I feel like I should delete this VOD after tonight. Oh man, I am walking a thin line. I love it. We can pass our own basket around to raise profits to make a Bible with guns and explosions. Exact. Oh my God. Are we business partners? Is this what's happening here? This is just good idea after good idea coming from you and from chat, and we got something going here. That reminds me of that meme of the guy killing demons in Doom in the presence of his very religious grandma. Oh no. She thought Harry Potter was bad? She thought Dungeons and Dragons was bad? Well, at least he's doing the Lord's work. Expelling the demons. Oh my God, I just looked over. I accidentally clicked. It happened again. It just went full screen on me. I legitimately...
Hi, thanks for checking in. I'm still a piece of garbage.
Did you hear the text-to-speech? I think it's pretty quiet. I'm gonna buff that again so you can hear text-to-speech.
Oh, hi. Thanks for checking in. I'm still a piece of garbage.
Boo. Loki, thank you so much for the 10 months at the tier one. I appreciate that. Welcome back, my friend. Back to you. Oh, man. The tab has been closed. I'm closing many, many tabs right now. I'm leaving my OnlyFans open and my Twitter open, and that is about it. Loki, hope you're having a good night. I'm gonna spam boop next time my resub comes up. That would be fantastic. Have you guys seen the trend on TikTok where if you put like the words yeah, YEAHHHHHHHHHH, like a super long word, yeah, in TikTok text, and you read it out loud, it sounds like the text-to-speech girl is coming. Or is that just me and my For You page? So about deleting the VOD. Yeah, I mean, you're never going to see this VOD again. Now, think of this as an exclusive broadcast where only you will ever see this and it will never be seen again. Is this when I finally get canceled? I have been trying to get canceled for years now. Everyone says they have the cancel button. They're ready to go. They are ready to press it. And then they never do. They pussy out. They're like, oh, Squake's not that bad. I'm like, cancel me. God, please. They squissy out. Oh. God. I get like a negative boner anytime someone says squissy or sky quissy. My penis goes like up and in, flies north for the winter. Isn't that what a squissy? Oh, oh wow. I don't know why I didn't think of that as I was saying that. Wow, I walked right into that. It's catching. No. It's not catching on. It's not. No. I Oh, man, I should have nipped this in the bud way before. Don't GG that. Don't GG that. Oh. Give me a perfect opening. What, talking about making a perfect opening? God. You're right, it just comes to you. That one was too easy. Man. I think that before I get canceled and start dissing religion even more and Republican anti-vax nut jobs and more anti-Kevin Sorbo propaganda, maybe I should call it a night. It's No Nut November and we're talking about squissies. I lost. Non-stop Nut November. It's like a fire hose. Dear God, this man. Chat, you're funny. Can I keep you around a little bit? Keep you around a little bit longer? You guys are funny. God, I don't say that often. I don't want to get into your heads, but if we're nuking this VOD from existence, I don't know if I'm gonna nuke the VOD, to be honest. I don't think I've said anything too crazy. How much will you pay me? I'm not paying you shit. That's not how this works. Anyway, type in the word yeah with a bunch of H's in TikTok. Please just try it. It has to be the girl voice. Also, have you guys heard that male TikTok text-to-speech voice, which is like weirdly sensual? It's like real weird. I refuse to use it. It's like strangely uncomfortable. Keep us around as long as you don't get canceled. That's true. I genuinely think that maybe saying this isn't great, but I don't do shit. I don't talk to anybody. Like, I'm never going to get canceled, and that bums me out. And one who also said that they're uncancelable, Gus Johnson. So maybe we don't jump into this train, but I don't talk to anybody. I don't send any gross DMs to anyone but Emily and Dave. Anyway, gonna go bleach my eyes and ears, probably for the best. It's been a night tonight. Squake, what lewd corner of TikTok do you live in? It's not bad, but again, it's just the default text-to-speech voices that TikTok provides. And I'm like, why are you doing this? Kaiser, Squake has one TikTok in particular that might give you an idea. I'll share it in Discord lit. Should I share that now? I'll share it now and I'll post it in Discord. How will you fight without a weapon? I know now I don't need the keyblade. I've got a better weapon. My heart. Yeah, we'll do this now. Follow me on TikTok, by the way. How do I want to do this? Alright, so this is not it.
Are you ready for the return of Ashigashi Mashi season? Are you ready for the return of Ashigashi Mashi season?
Ew! Ew! That's a mushroom! Who fucking calls it Ashigashi Mashi season? That was February in college for me. Every February around Valentine's Day? God. gross. What good will that weak little thing do for you? You saw him reply to my comment? I don't think, at least. I mean, if I haven't done it now, I'm not doing it. Because I haven't realized that it was there or whatever. Did I really not? I want to check because it didn't show up on there. Oh, yeah, you just said we need answers. No answers. Biggie? I genuinely hovered over your name for a ban for a second. Because that... Ugh! All right. I am out of here. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your night. I don't know if any of us can after tonight. That was 2.5 hours of... That was something. I am not going to nuke the VOD. I have buried, or I have dug my grave. I'm ready to jump in. Kaiser, Tyler, Time Watcher, Biggie, Sheep, Brandino, Diana, Raven, Bathtub, anyone else who may be lurking, hanging out that I may have missed. I know Snow Hero was here. AD was here. Exact Plays, if I didn't already say your name already. Loki gave the sub. Thank you all so much for being here. I'm just going to hop off for the night. I'm not going to raid anyone. I'm feeling like just bouncing. So I will be back, or I should be back on Sunday. Should be back on Sunday. So with that, I hope you all will be there, hopefully to actually beat Metroid Dread, because we did not tonight. Tonight was just a just chatting stream of just fucking around. Thunder Buddies now were DeBrune. No, I'm going to veto that. Have a good night. I love you all. I will see you in Discord. Post your pet pics and your lewd TikToks, or don't. Maybe I shouldn't say that. Have a good night. Bye-bye.